Hello friends, welcome to the channel Solution. Today in this video we will tell you how to take accurate reading of upper and lower meniscus of any liquid inside the burette. So first of all, here we have filled colorless liquid, here it is water, inside the burette.
This video is also available in Hindi explanation. Link of the video is given in the description box. When measuring the liquids inside the burette, it is essential to understand the concept of upper and lower meniscus. The upper meniscus refers to the curved surface of the liquid at the top, while the lower meniscus is the curved surface at the bottom.
And here, this point means this upper level of surface of water is called upper meniscus, and this point means this lower level of surface of liquid is called lower meniscus of the liquid. And when we have a colorless liquid or colored liquid, and when the lower meniscus of liquid is visible inside the burette, then we have to fill it in such a way that the lower meniscus of liquid touches the zero line of the burette. And when we start the titration and when the end point is reached, means upon the completion of reaction, then we have to measure the volume of liquid consumed during the titration. So, at the time of measuring the volume, we need to apply the same concept, that is, when the lower meniscus of the liquid is visible, we have to take the reading of lower meniscus only. As you can see here, the lower meniscus of liquid touches the line 5.3. So here the volume of liquid consumed during titration is 5.3 ml. Here we have taken another solution in the burette, that is copper sulfate solution, which is a blue colored solution. Since the lower meniscus of copper sulfate solution is easily visible inside the burette, fill this copper sulfate solution in the burette in such a way that the lower meniscus touches the zero line of the burette. And then again we start the titration, and after the completion of titration, then again we have to measure the volume of copper sulfate solution consumed during titration. Even though it is a colored solution, the lower meniscus is clearly visible. So we have to take the reading of lower meniscus only. Here you can see the lower meniscus of copper sulfate touches the line 5.8. So here the volume of copper sulfate solution consumed is 5.8 ml. Generally, there is a misconception that if the solution is colored, then we have to take the reading of upper meniscus, and if the solution is colorless, then we have to take the reading of lower meniscus. But this is wrong. Burette reading is not based on the color of solution. If the lower meniscus is visible, we always take the reading of lower meniscus only. But if the lower meniscus is not visible, generally in the case of dark color solution, then only we have to take the reading with upper meniscus.
This is because the lower meniscus represents the actual liquid level, whereas the upper meniscus can be influenced by the surface tension, curvature or other factors that might affect the accuracy of the measurement. So to ensure the accurate result, it is very important to focus on the lower meniscus when taking the measurement.
So to demonstrate this, next we have taken the solution of potassium permanganate. Here you can see the color of solution is so dark that the lower meniscus of liquid is not visible. So in this case, we have to take the reading of upper meniscus. So we have to fill this liquid in the burette in such a way that the upper meniscus touches the zero line of the burette. And then again start the titration, and after the completion of titration, again measure the volume of KM4 consumed. And here we have to take the reading of upper meniscus.
So here you can see the upper meniscus of the liquid touches the line 3.8. So here the volume consumed is 3.8 ml. Thank you very much for watching this video.